Thank you, Dr. Buki. I'm particularly honored and proud to be here in PECH and in this prestigious academy to deliver this hopefully short and fascinating lecture that in some way may be connected with the previous speakers. And let me start with the first word of my presentation, that is connections. Connections is now a brilliant word that we use in everyday practice, the internet, the net, and the languages. I'm Italian, we are in Hungary, I'm speaking English, this is connection. We found a common path to discuss together and stay together. I come from Sicily, that you know is the center of the Mediterranean Sea, in a special place that is dedicated to myth. Ulysses crosses the Strait of Messina, facing my city, Messina, and its beauty. But again, the connection, the mentor, my brother and friend, Andras, is Dr. Doxy, comes from a similar route from where we come, so again, connection. Professor Yasher Gill in Zurich, and my mentor invited him a long time ago to a meeting in Taormina that we both know and remember. But again, I'm here to explain you why an Hungarian neurosurgeon or a group of Hungarian neurosurgeons and neuroscientists can be linked and form a connection with the Italian neurosurgeon in Messina. And again in this area, because we are centered on a new visualization and a new organization of the brain that started from anatomy, as we have seen from the speaker that was previous to me, and now the connection and the hubs and the node and the path and the fibers and the centers and the location and even the culture, the languages, the visualization, the memory, don't have a special site. For a joke, a long time ago, I wrote a manuscript that was dedicated to the location of the soul. If we have a soul, it should be somewhere, and we probably put in the brain, but where? And the soul is the clue of our connection, of our culture, of our religious, and our training. But we need to move these ideas and these strategies to the living brain and to the daily practice as we do in our daily OR. Thinking that we started from different area located in the brain, but what we have understood through the years is that their connection that make unique the brain and we as human beings. In our OR and in our practice, we have a tons of intra and pre and post operative technologies that allows us to know where we are, to understand where we go, and with tools that at the beginning were sophisticated, expensive, rare, but now it is just useful, even an iPhone. Some of our technology can be important in the iPhone or in the telephone that you've got in your pocket and do neurosurgery or do brilliant stuff as we try to do. And I want to present why and how we can translate this information. That it seems like a joke, but do we really need them? Absolutely yes. As we can be disoriented today without maps, without Google, without telephone, without nets, we can be disoriented in a modern way to interpret brain surgery and the brain connection. And the need of preoperative neurophysiological mapping is a clue stuff even today in 2019. That is necessary and is so necessary that don't need any kind of validation. It's something if you want for a joke to assess if we really need a parachute when we jump from the flight instead to get destroyed by a diffuse injury. We don't need it. It's clear that it is something that is important. And we translate and use simple tools to daily practice and again, the connection they want to establish is to make a joint program between the Department on research at the University of Pécs and the Department of Research at the University of Messina, trying to enlarge this collaboration to other groups, and probably this is the real sense of my visit at this prestigious institution. But let's start from the experience that we are joining together that is has been anticipated, is by the use of this navigated transcranial magnetic stimulation that is a tool through which we can stimulate the cerebral cortex like this in single dots, assessing the area that is around a brain lesion and trying to assess and to realize what are the links between the lesion and between the normal brain and between the function that are located in that particular area. And we can do that in a three-dimensional way, because we have seen from the previous speakers the brain is a 3D organ that has its own orientation and its own set of architectonics, and we can have a cortical effect that is going to be deep, although remains in the cerebral cortex in the in the single layer. And we can transport this stimulation to the living patient and stimulate separately the hand, the foot, or the face. For example, as you see through twinkling, I stimulate a specific part of the brain of this patient and I obtain a motor response in the hand, in the foot, and in the face separately, and I can assess the exact relationship between the lesion and the motor area and the function of this patient, importing this information in a three-dimensional tool. And again, in my OR, where I can separate the lesion and this relationship with a motor fiber for the arm, for the leg, and for the face, trying to spare the function that in this particular case is just related to the motor activity, but I can translate in every single function you imagine in your life, such as the visuospatial activities, as we have seen before, or memory, or emotion, or pain, or sensation, or so far, where are the neurological functions located. But let's go back to the anatomy, and we have heard how now we search for the omega to see where the central knob is, and in the contralateral brain, where the central knob can be in somewhat distorted, we may assess the relationship between the lesion per se and the anatomy of the functional brain in two separate cases. Every neurosurgeon is able to imagine how tricky it can be to treat a case like that, because the risk at the end of the procedure to have a paralysis on the contralateral brain is very high. But through the analysis we do, we can functionally assess where the anatomic, where the functional location of the motor area is, that in this case is exactly in the front, and in this particular case is not located in the front, as the NTMS showed to you, separating the fibers and the connection for, again, the arm, the leg, and the face. So this is a safe case, the lesion is far away. In this particular case, the lesion is in the central sulcus and the patient may really have a paralysis. That means that it is a poor patient, or we discharge the case? No. This means that we need to study the brain in a new way in order to save the life of our patient while saving his neurological function, that in these cases is just the motor function. And again, exporting in our OR, here is the 3D reconstruction of the spots for the motor area in these cases and in this one. We have been able through the years to publish these cases and to separate according to a cortical reorganization the fiber for the leg, the fiber for the arm, and for the face prior to joint in the corticospinal tract that the previous speakers have described to you, and you all know probably, I guess. This is another example where we can use the subcortical connection through what now is called diffuse tensory imaging and the DTI fibers originate in order to assess the relationship between the lesion and the normal fibers as related to language function. Just to give you an example of another function that can be assessed through these tools. We use this technology in hundreds of patients. We started 8 years ago in 2011 and started to publish the first manuscript in 2004, studying, of course, in glioma, which is a terrible brain tumor, in this variant in low-grade and high-grade glioma. But we have been able to export this technology in the daily practice also of other neurological and neurosurgical diseases such as metastasis or cavernous malformation or arteriovenous malformation. And this is part of the list of the publication we have done through years, including a meta-analysis or the direct translation of these tools in the neurosurgically daily practice, combining echography, intraoperative CT scan, intraoperative fluorescein in different brain disease. Let me show you some cases. For example, again, a man with a tumor close to the motor area, the separation between the face, the arm and the leg, and the reconstruction in the OR and the operative setting. This is one of the tools that you also in PATCH have in your neurosurgery, where you can 3D transfer the images and the reconstruction of the lesion and the relationship with the motor fibers, again of the arm, of the face, and of the leg, in order to operate well this patient and to save not only his life, but also his neurological function. The direct brain stimulation, very fastly, and the responses that we have confirming what was the preoperative mapping that we had in advance, the intraoperative demonstration of the lesion, and the final results with a patient that is doing very well with a sparing of his motor function despite an eloquent and crazy and particular location of the lesion I've shown to you. This is another case where in this case the lesion is located in an area that is involved in language production and language comprehension. The patient is assessed not for motor function but for language mapping. The information is exported in a modern map that is able to differentiate the single area of the brain according to the function that is searched. And again, this is the NTMS with the relationship of the lesion with the Rolandic fissure, with the Sylvian fissure, with the language area and the corina map for the distribution of this neurological function, the reconstruction in color of the fibers and of the tract that can be involved in this surgery, and again, intraoperative validation, where we are and what function we save or put at risk in this particular case, and the intraoperative reconstruction.
I have been operated 7 days ago and everything has gone well.
So this patient have a language saved, as we ask for the neurosurgery, please operate my brain, took out my disease, but save my neurological function. And these can be also used to treat some benign disease. These are different kind of patient with what seems to be a normal neurosurgical cases is a meningioma, is a benign tumor that as an iceberg circundates the corticospinal tract, and we have to take care not only of the cortical surface but most importantly of the downsizing and down-seated corticospinal fibers, intraoperative validation that we, you, Andres, and Dr. Doxy do every day, also in PATCH, the respect of the normal function, and at the end, the removal total of the brain, of the lesion, with salvage of the neurological function of the patient. Again, this can be also used for what is called the arteriovenous malformation, which are vascular disease. Here again, the relationship between the lesion, the vessels, the Rolandic fissure, and the hand knob that we have seen since the beginning of this conversation. The 3D reconstruction in the preoperative setting and in the OR according to the motor fibers, and the planning that has been offered to this patient and the treatment that has been offered that is at this point safe, effective. I will show it to you in a minute, and pre and post operative angiography with complete removal of the arteriovenous malformation and the sparing of the neurological function of these cases. In addition, we can also use this tool to assess the postoperative reorganization that the patient may have at the end of the procedure. In conclusion, these tools exist in Messina since 8 years, and it allowed us to expand our horizon and to include our colleagues such as Professor Tomaiolo that preceded me in this talk, allowed us to bring connection with neurologists, psychiatrists, anatomists, engineering, radiologists, to better understand how the brain is functioning. I want to explore this connection, putting a bridge between Messina and PETCH with you, with a focus on assessing the neurological function, and with the final goal to save the life and the function of our neurological patient. I thank you for the patience and for this opportunity.